Hi, I'm Zach with Superstrata, and I want to talk a little bit more about what we mean when we say the Superstrata is a super tough bike, because toughness has a very specific meaning to engineers, and it's not just one of those marketing adjectives that we throw around. So engineers think about toughness as how much energy a structure can absorb before it fails. And to talk about toughness, they use things like stress and strain to describe that behavior. So you can think about stress as in like how much force a structure can withstand before failure in a given direction. And strain is like how much deflection it can withstand. And specifically, stress is area normalized force, and strain is area normalized deflection. You can think of it like that. So for example, if I plot stress on the vertical axis, and I plot strain on the horizontal axis here, so increasing here in force, this would be increasing stress, and increasing deflection, stretching out the structure more, that's increasing strain. So engineers will further characterize materials in terms of whether how they fail. So a structure might fail more brittly or more ductily. Brittle failure, ductile failure. And this is, a brittle failure would be indicative of a ceramic material, like a coffee cup shattering. That's very brittle failure. Whereas a ductile failure would be more like a plastic that stretches a lot before it finally snaps. A rubber band is very ductile, and maybe that's even getting into a third category of elastomers, but we won't get into that. So if I were to show a ductile failure mode, I would say that first I would load up a structure, and it would have some linear part there. And we call that part the elastic region, where if I unload it, it goes right back down to where it was, no deformation. And that's where we really design the structure to be. But then, let's say we run our bike into a telephone pole. That's no good. We've now gone into the so-called plastic region here, where now this curve here, this is a permanent deformation on the bike, but it hasn't failed yet. It's going to keep going until eventually we're going to reach some critical point where it just can't take it anymore. It's going to fail. Now, contrast that with, let's say, a more brittle thermoset bike, a more traditionally manufactured bike. That might have slightly more stiffness in the beginning, but then very quickly it's going to peak out and fail prematurely. And some things to note here are that the amount of stress, how high this curve is, that's about the same between the brittle thermoset bike and the more ductile, tougher thermoplastic bike. So they've taken about the same amount of load, and they have about the same amount of stiffness, but this bike took a lot more strain. And specifically, the area under this curve right here, that area is defined as the toughness. So you can think on the red curve here, the brittle curve, we've only got this much area, whereas on the black curve, the superstrata curve, we've got a lot more area, so it's a lot tougher. And that's the definition of engineering toughness in this case. So if you have a bike here, at this point here, this bike has permanently bent. It is deformed, and that's bad, but at least it's still rideable, and it's still in one piece, critically. So this amount of strain, that amount of impact, you can ride that bike home, and you can, importantly, it's still in one piece. You aren't lying on the road with the pieces of your shattered thermoset bike sitting around you. So that's a very positive thing for crash worthiness here. So thank you. I hope you understand a little bit more about toughness and what we mean when we say this Superstrata is super tough. Bye.